have seen me. Blessed are those who have not seen, and yet have come to believe. Good old Thomas. You know, back in the 20th century, we would have said he was from Missouri. In the 21st century, he's probably a progressive college student from some university, and he says, yeah, right, and my mother is Madonna. A total skeptic. So who is this Thomas? Not who was he, but who is he now? When we hear this story, who do we picture in our mind? Someone we work with? Someone in our family? A neighbor? Or perhaps ourselves? We live in a world of skeptics now. Nobody believes in anything anymore. It's all fake news. You can't trust what you read in the paper. You can't trust what you see on TV. You can't even trust your own eyes anymore. What they do with special effects in movies and in photos, Photoshop, can make anything look like anything. Has that woman really looked as good as she appears? Or has she been digitally altered? Just how tall is George?
There is only one answer. You must have faith. You must believe.
computer science, information management, communications, networking. All these degrees heavily based on our current technology. Another great buzzword of the modern age. You know, you used to have to look things out of books. You had to go to the library, or several libraries. Many moons ago, when I went to the Center for the Deacon, I had to go to Lewis and Clark Library, or the library at the University of Portland. You know, you always got to go to Catholic universities to get the best library. I had to get the information I needed to write my papers. That was what I had to do. Now, it's just a couple of mouse clicks away. You find it on the web. Some of us can get really good at this, you know. We get our favorite sites down, Wikipedia. For those clergy folks, we get Bible Gateway or another Bible site. Oh, and then there's WebMD. Your diagnosis is just one click away. So much knowledge. But is it really knowledge? We're in the throes of the new age of enlightenment. Knowledge is power. But in this case, it's not just knowledge. In fact, it's not knowledge at all. It's really more information. And we equate information with knowledge. I can find out anything about anything on the web. Pick a subject, any subject. Put it in your search engine, click the button, and boom! All of a sudden, you have more information on that subject than you can possibly imagine. One click. You have 24,000 returns. Which makes it then you can be even more specific and pick the information on the subject that you like, that agrees with your worldview. And of course, all of it is the gospel truth. The world is flat. You know, I saw it on the web. Well, the truth is, I get information, but is it really knowledge? What do I know? It's become so easy for us now to substitute information for faith. I don't have to believe in anything. I don't have to trust anyone else. I can make my own decision about what is true. Finding all of the information that's available to me on the web. This access to all this information has its definite benefits, but it has one horrible side effect. We think we know all the answers, or if we don't know them, we can search and find. And bingo, the web is our God. The web knows all. We have no need for faith or a belief system or any of that touchy-feely stuff that all you churchgoers want to rely on. We have substituted our access to information for any kind of a need to believe in God or Jesus or resurrection or anything else. Now, the truth is, and it's probably a little bit more subtle than what I'm making it look like here, but I wonder how many people out there are turning more to their computer than to their Bible or prayer book. For how many people is it true that the first response to any of life's deep questions is, well, I think I'll look that up on the internet. The internet is our doctor, our shrink, our philosopher, our muse, our subject matter expert on anything and everything. Don't get me started on religion or politics. So who is Thomas today? Well, I think Thomas today is all of those people who hear the word of God, through the message of the resurrection, but don't understand or even feel a need to believe. I have knowledge. I have information. So I don't need to believe. Maybe Jesus did rise from the dead. The disciples tell Thomas, we have seen the Lord. And Thomas says, well, let me look that up on the web. We need to bring to mind for this age something very basic. How to have faith. How to believe. Knowledge will eventually fail. Information will not provide all the answers. Some churches have virtual services. All you do is sit in front of your computer and go to church. The info evangelist, next step up from the televangelist. I suppose web pages and things like Facebook for churches are good up to a point. They're a wonderful way to let people know what's going on, where the service schedules are. It's just like an ad in the paper. But it's not a substitute for faith. It's not a substitute for a way to build faith. I still believe faith is built the old-fashioned way, by the witness of one person to another. We want to teach people to believe in God, to believe in Jesus and the resurrection. We need to testify to them, to bring the message to them, and not on a web page, but face to face. We need to tell the story of our faith and not be ashamed that we didn't find it on the internet. We need to witness to the fact that the faith in God goes deeper, that it is something more than what information can provide. Jesus said, "I have come that you may have life and have it abundantly." There is more to life than information. There are more answers to life's questions than mere information can provide. Faith and belief in the testimony of witnesses. What individuals say, not what the web says. So witness to people. Tell them what it is to have faith. Witness to people what it means to believe in something. What it means to believe in Jesus and to believe in the resurrection. Help people learn that there is a place in their lives for faith. I think there are too many people who just don't know that. And you could witness that faith simply by sharing who you are. Let them know that you are who you are because of your faith, and that that's not a bad thing. It's not a crutch. It's not a weakness. It's not a second choice because you didn't have enough information and you decided to fill in the blank with faith. Your faith comes first. It says,